Welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss about equipment to control particulate matter. Welcome. Equipment to control particulate matter. It comes under fourth unit. So, and in previous session, we have seen about the list of equipments which are in practice and which are used to control the particulate matter from polluted gas streams. So what are the equipments are in practice there? First one is settling chamber. Next one is inertial separators. And third one is cyclone separators, or simply they are called as cyclones. And fourth one is fabric filters. Fifth one is electrostatic precipitators. And sixth one is scrubbers or wet collectors. So these are the six types of equipments which are in practice, and these are used to control the particulate matter from the polluted gas streams. So first one is, coming to first one, it is settling chamber. In settling chamber, we will use gravitational force to make the settlement of particulate matter, and then we can separate them. And about the settling chamber, we have discussed in previous session. And in inertial separator, we will use a combination of three forces to make the separation of particulate matter from the polluted gas streams. So what are the three forces? Centrifugal forces and gravity and inertia. By employing these three forces on the polluted gas stream inside a chamber, we can separate the particulate matter from the gas stream. And under inertial separators, based on their working or based on their principle of operation, we are having three more types of inertial separators. What are they? We have discussed already in previous session. Again, I am briefing them. There, first one is baffle type separator. Next one is lower type separator. And third one is dust traps. And in cyclones, coming to cyclones, third one is cyclones. In cyclones, we will use, first of all, we will employ centrifugal force on polluted gas stream inside a chamber. After that, the gas stream can undergo cyclonic motion. So, and due to application of centrifugal force on the gaseous flow or gaseous stream, it can undergo cyclonic motion, and then the particulates can be separated out from the gas streams. So these are the three types of equipments what we have been discussed in previous session. And one more thing we have to remember is the settling chamber can remove the particles whose size is greater than 50 microns. If the particle size is less than 50 microns, the settling chamber cannot separate those particles 50 microns. And inertial separator, we are having three types of separator, inertial separators. First one is baffle type. In baffle type separator, we can separate or we can remove only particles whose size is greater than 20 microns. And in lower type separator, we can separate particles whose size is greater than 30 microns. And in dust traps, we can separate particles whose size is greater than 20 microns. These are the values what we have to remember. And in cyclones, we can separate particles whose size is greater than 10 microns. So all these things we have to remember. Only these are the important. What are the forces and what is the principle involving in the operation of these three types of equipment? And what is the particle size of particles we can separate by using these three types of equipment we have seen in previous class. And in this session, we are going to discuss about these three types of equipment. First one is fabric filters, electrostatic precipitator, and scrubbers. In fabric filters, we will use filtration process to separate the particulate matter from the polluted gas streams. And in electrostatic precipitators, we will create a strong electromagnetic field. First of all, we will create a strong electromagnetic field, and then we will allow the polluted gas stream to pass through the electromagnetic field. While the gas stream is flowing or moving through that field, automatically the particulate matter can be separated out from the gas stream. And next one is scrubber. In scrubbers or wet collectors, we will use liquids to separate the particulate matter from the gas stream. And mostly we will use water as a scrubbing liquid or collecting liquid. And what are the principles of these three types of equipment, and what is the process involving in their operation, and what are their advantages, disadvantages, applications, we are going to see in this session. Control of particulate matter. So see, these are the contents I'm going to cover now. Introduction, settling chambers, inertial separators, cyclones, filters, electrostatic precipitator, scrubbers and wet collectors. And already I told you that about settling chambers, inertial separators and cyclones we have discussed in previous sessions. So now we are not going to discuss about these things. And in this session, we are going to discuss about filters, electrostatic precipitators, and scrubbers only. So already we have seen all these things. So coming to filters. Filters or fabric filters are also called as fabric collectors or cloth filters or bag filters or bag house. Fabric collectors use filtration process to separate particulates from polluted gas streams. So in this diagram, you can see that here at the top, it is a chamber. It is a completely closed chamber. It is a rectangular chamber. Inside this rectangular chamber completely called as a bag house. In this diagram, you can see that at the end, there is a rod, or it is called as manifold. To that manifold, there number of you can see that number of bags, these are all the bags which are hanging over the manifold. So see here, number of bags are hanging from the manifold. These are all the bags. And inside the chamber, we will allow the dirty gas or polluted gas. See that here, what are the parts I'm showing here? This is the inlet for the dusty gas, and this is the outlet for the clean air, and these are the filter bags. All these are the filter bags. And at the top left end, we are having a vibrator. it is used to vibrate or to compact the bags. So only the here we will follow only simple technique, very simple. It is very simple to operate this. You can see here. First of all, we will allow the polluted gas inside the chamber, and then we will close the inlet. Then the entered gas in the chamber, it will filled in the bags. In these bags, it will be filled in these bags. After that, by using this vibrator, we will compact all these bags. When we compact all these bags, the air present in the bags will be come out, and the particulates present in the gas will be, it means they will remain within the bags. And then at the after some time, we can separate the particulate matter or dust particles remained within the bags. That's it. That is the process. Simply, we will, it means the process is nothing but here we are allowing the gas to enter into the bag. After that, we will compress the bag. Once we compress, the air entered in the bag will be expelled. It will come out through the voids, and then the particles only, they remain in the, they settle in the bags. After that, we can dispose that particulate matter. That's it. See, you can see here. Here we can see polluted gases enter the bag house and pass through the fabric bags that act as filters. The bags can be of woven or cotton or synthetic or glass fiber material in either a tube or envelope shape. In this system, the entered gas allowed to pass through these bags, which filters out the particulate matter and allows the gas to escape. Small particles are retained on the fabric later on when the dust mat will be formed. Frequently, the bags or filter material should be cleaned or replaced. Small particles can retain in the bag. Fabric filters can remove particle of size about 1 micrometer. So this is the important point we have to remember here. This is fabric filters can remove particles whose size is greater than 1 micrometer. So it is the 99% of efficient, and it can remove particles in between 1 micrometer to 10 micrometers. And the factors affecting efficiency of this fabric filter is improper selection of filter media, temperature of gas stream, particle size of particulate matter. And the advantages of fabric filter are higher collection efficiency. It collects particles smaller than 10 micrometers. It requires normal power consumption. And the disadvantages are high temperature gases need to be cooled. High initial and maintenance cost. It needs, its initial and maintenance cost is too much high compared to the remaining types of equipment, and it needs high fabric replacement cost, and large size, it is a large sized equipment, and the fabric is liable to chemical attack. The applications, it means where we can utilize or where we can employ this fabric filter is, in fabric filter generally we can employ it metallurgical industry, foundries, cement industry, ceramic industry, floor mills, and brickworks. And next type of equipment is electrostatic precipitators. Electrostatic precipitator is a device that removes suspended dust particles from a gas or exhaust by applying a high voltage electrostatic charge and collecting the particles on charged plates. Electrostatic precipitates can remove particles whose size is less than 1 micrometer, and its efficiency is about 99%. It means its efficiency between 95% to 99%. And one here in electrostatic precipitator, we will provide two plates. They are called as electrodes. Two electrodes we will use, and the two electrodes will be charged with high voltage. Whenever we charged the two electrodes with high voltage. In between the two plates, a strong electromagnetic field will be created. And whenever the polluted gas will be moved through that strong electromagnetic field, it means in between the two plates, whenever the polluted gas stream will move or will flow, in that time, at that time, the particulates will automatically get settled on or deposited on the surface of these two electrodes. That's it. Only that is the process here. You can see here. In this method, two electrodes are fitted inside a chamber. When high voltage is applied, an electric discharge takes place in between these two plates. As a result, a strong electromagnetic field will be created. The air in this strong electromagnetic field gets ionized. The ionized air consists of ions and free electrons. See that? See here. This is a chamber. In this chamber, we are using two electrode plates. And whenever we charge them with high voltage, in between these two electrodes, a strong electromagnetic field will be generated. And the air or the space in within the strong electromagnetic field, automatically it will be ionized. And the matter in that electromagnetic field will be in the form of ions. See, if the polluted gas allowed to pass through the strong electromagnetic field, the particulate matter get negatively charged and attracted to positively charged electrodes. Therefore, the particulate matter settle down on the surfaces of the electrode plates. These can be dislodged by vibrating the electrodes. That's it, by shaking or by vibrating the electrode plates, the settled particles can be removed, or they will be dislodged. So this is the equipment or chamber which is used as an electrostatic precipitator in industries. So see, the electrostatic precipitator should contain the following components: a source of high voltage, electrode plates, inlet and outlet for the gas, a hopper for disposal of collected gases, a cleaning system, an outer casing to form an enclosure around the electrodes. These are the six parts which are must for an electrostatic precipitator. Once again, we see a source of high voltage, electrode plates, inlet and outlet for the gas, a hopper which is provided at the bottom of the chamber, and a cleaning system which is generally a vibrating system which is used to vibrate the electrodes, and outer casing, it means a chamber walls. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of electrostatic precipitator. The advantages are the particles may be collected wet or dry. It means the electrostatic precipitator can collect wet particles and also dry particles it can collect. And even the small particles can be removed. It means it can remove the particles whose size is less than 1 micrometer. And they can be operated at high temperatures up to 450 degrees centigrade. Their maintenance cost is nominal. And the disadvantages of electrostatic precipitator are they need higher initial cost, and they are sensitive to variable dust loadings and flow rates, and the collection efficiency will be reduced with time. And the applications of electrostatic precipitator. The electrostatic precipitators we can employ at various industries like cement factories, pulp and paper industries, steel plants, non-ferrous metal industry, chemical industry, petroleum industry, and power plants. And next one and the final equipment is the scrubbers. Scrubbers are also called as wet collectors. Scrubbers utilize liquids, generally water, to assist in the removal of particulates from the carrier gas stream. In wet collectors, the particulate matter is agglomerated with water and then separated from the gas with water. Scrubbers can separate particles even smaller than 0.2 micrometers. In scrubbers, we're having two types of equipment only based on their operation. First one is spray tower and next one is the cyclone separator. So coming to first, we discuss about spray tower. It is a simple type of equipment. In this, we will have a cylindrical chamber or rectangular chamber, and from the at the bottom we will have an inlet for the polluted gas, and at the top we will have an outlet for the cleaned gas, and at the bottom, it means at the belowmost, we will have a one more outlet, that is to collect the liquid and particles. We can see that in this chamber, at various levels, we will have a different nozzles. Through that nozzles, the water will be spread, and the water through the nozzles will move in downward direction, and the polluted gas will move in upward direction. While the polluted gas is moving in upward direction and the water is spraying and moving in the downward direction, the water droplets, they can hold the particulate matter, and they can bring the particulate matter with them to the bottom. That's it. That is the principle here. You can see that here. Spray tower is the simplest type of wet scrubber. In this scrubber, gas is passed counter current to falling drops of liquid from a series of nozzles. Counter current means opposite direction. In this scrubber, gas is passed in opposite direction to the following drops of liquid from a series of nozzles. The impingement and interception of particles with liquid droplets cause settlement of particles along with liquid droplets. Spray towers are used to separate coarse particles. Second one is the cyclone scrubber. Cyclone scrubbers are another type of wet collector. In cyclone scrubber, it is same like in as in spray tower. In cyclone scrubber also, we will use liquid to collect the particulate matter. And but in, see here, at high pressure, the nozzle sprays water, and the sprayed water within the chamber, it will rotate and it will undergo some cyclonic action. And whenever the water is rotating within the chamber, the particles can exert a centrifugal force. So at high pressure, nozzle sprays water within the chamber, and the particles in the air, they can exert, due to the motion of the liquid or due to the motion of the water, the particulate matter entered in the chamber, they can exert centrifugal force and they can move towards the walls, and they can strike the walls, and then they can set it out. It is like cyclone separator. In cyclone separator, directly we will employ or we will apply centrifugal force on the airflow itself, but here we will use liquid. And then see here, cyclone scrubbers are another type of wet collectors. High pressure nozzle sprays located inside the chamber, they generate a fine spray that intercepts particles entrained in the swirling gases. The particulate matter is thrown onto the walls by centrifugal action and then drain it to the bottom. That is the simple operation here. And see, the advantages of scrubbers is, these scrubbers are wet collectors. They can remove particulate matters as well as gaseous pollutants at a time. And they can remove, it means mostly the spray towers or scrubbers are used as a cooling agents. And in these scrubbers, hard gases can be cooled down and the corrosive gases can be recovered and neutralized. The disadvantages are lot of wastewater produced maintenance cost is high. This is the important thing, because already we have discussed about various types of equipments. We have discussed like settling chamber, inertial separator, cyclone separator, fabric filter, electrostatic precipitator, and scrubbers. And in previous session we had discussed about the most important thing is the selection of the proper equipment for a proper for a particular process or for a particular industry or for a particular kind of gas stream. Understand or not? So the choice of equipment based on some criteria, while we are selecting the equipment, the type of equipment or the particular equipment, we need to keep all these things in mind. The first one is particulate size, particulate loading, required efficiency, and the properties of carrier gas like composition, temperature, pressure, viscosity, density, humidity, ignitability, reactivity, electrical property, etc. And flow characteristics of carrier gas, it means its velocity, discharge, acceleration, all these things. And capital and operating cost of the equipment. Last one is age of maintenance and reliability. So in the selection of equipment for a particular process, we need to keep all these things in mind. Economic aspects, this is the important one. Cyclones, it means what kind of operation or what kind of parameter for a equipment will demand large, it means high cost, and what kind of operation will need low cost. That's what we have to see here. Cyclones, they are cheap to install and their power consumption is moderate and their maintenance cost is normal. The filters, they are expensive to install and they need medium power consumption and their maintenance cost is high. And electrostatic precipitators, they are more expensive and their initial cost and maintenance cost is too much high compared to the remaining equipments, and they need normal power consumption and their maintenance cost is moderate, but they need their maintenance cost and initial cost is too much high. And scrubbers, their installation cost is moderate, maintenance cost is not that much high, and they need high rate of power consumption. That's it. Thank you.